Hi, this is Mike Sayers from Mechanical Simulation. This video is going to show how we use VS Visualizer, a tool that's provided with CarSim, TruckSim, BikeSim, and Suspension Sim. The VS stands for Vehicle Sim, which is the technology used in all of our products. If you've seen any other of our videos, you've already seen the visualizer, and you know it's used for animation and plotting. This particular video is an instructional for new users of our software to see how to manipulate things. When you start out, you are looking at the Run Control screen, and there's a video button up here that you can right-click and get instructions, a video plus plot, or a plot. We've chosen the video plus plot to get all of them combined up here. Now, when the video is running, we control where the camera is located by right-clicking and dragging horizontally on the screen to fly around it. If we go up and down, we're going up it and below it. Interesting feature is that when you're underground, you can see up, it's transparent, so you can see all the dynamics underneath. If I want to get closer or further away, I use both buttons. This gets me close, this gets me far away. If I hold the control key while moving up and down with both buttons, it changes my distance and also the zoom. It keeps the car pretty much at the same size, but everything else changes. I can change the direction that the camera is aiming by holding the shift key down and right clicking. You'll see that the center, the point that the camera is aimed at, has little axes showing there. And if I go left and right, it's the same as swinging the camera to the left and the right without changing its position. I can stop by using the pause button down here and restart. I can also use the space bar if the camera is active. I can use the arrow keys to go just a little bit to the left, go a little bit to the right, or hold it down for kind of a semi-slow motion. At any time, I can see where I am by looking at the lower right corner. This is telling me that we're in a 6.3 second run and that we're 3.85 seconds into it. Now, along with the camera, I've got plots over here. There's a divider that I can use to change the amount of screen real estate that goes to the plots and the camera. And these plots are kind of small. They're the small view, but I can double click and see it in a larger view. It fills the panel. If I want to see the values associated with the variables on here, I type V and it gives me that information. Up on the help screen, I can get all the commands for the camera with one setting, and I can get all the settings for the plot window with another one. We've got a lot more for the plots. Some of the things I can do, like the camera, if I right click, I can go around and change the view of what part of the data I'm looking at. If I hold both of them together, I zoom in, zoom out. If I go into the vertical axis and right click, I can go up and down while leaving the horizontal unaffected. Or I can go into the horizontal and do the same thing, leaving the vertical unaffected. I can go into the vertical and hold both of them down and stretch that to get things slid around. I can do the same thing on the left. If I want to zoom in and look at one part in particular, I draw a rectangle with the left button and it zooms in to do that. If I want to go back to the normal view, restore it, I type R. I'll go back to the grid. I can go through the plots on here. You see that this one is highlighted, the first one. If I go page down, it goes around and views the other ones. That was page up. Here's page down. So I can cycle through them like that. If I type Z, that is zoom. So if it's zoomed in, it will zoom out. If it's zoomed out, it will zoom in. To see the maximum value, type Control with the up arrow. And you see that we're right here. It's 83 degrees positive. Notice that when I do that, the time skips to that value, 0.075 seconds, and I see what the car looks like there. If I do Control down, that takes me to the minimum, minus 104 degrees at the steering wheel, and this is what the vehicle looked like at that point. It's also possible to make new plots and define the variables interactively. Check the Create New Plot up here. Over on View, there's an option called Data Manager that lists all the variables that are in the output file. So let's go down and say we want to get X coordinates of some wheel centers. I drag the name into the new plot, and there they are plotted. Everything we've been looking at has been at regular playback speed, but we also have advanced controls up here. Under view, there's a time multiplier, and there are advanced playback controls. The time multiplier is a nice one. It's got a shuttle that lets me go backwards and forwards in slow motion. We have other controls down here to go backward normal speed, forward normal speed, and others. Now, almost everything we've seen in this video is described in a quick start guide that comes with your software. Go to the Help menu and go down to Guides and Tutorials, and whether you're in CarSim, TruckSim, or BikeSim, there is a quick start guide that takes you through all the features that we've just seen. That concludes our video. Thanks for watching.